Henry Highland Garnet was born here in Kent County in 1815.
Henry Highland Garnet was simply one of the most important men ever born in Kent County.
I didn't see him, but according to his picture, he was a very handsome man.
It's a very important man to know that, and we're still learning history from his past.
He was a minister, an educator, and also a great public speaker.
Henry Highland Garnet was the first African American to address Congress.
Henry Highland Garnet was a great abolitionist as well as a great preacher who fought for the rights of all blacks to be free.
He had a purpose, he had a plan, and he was prepared to go through anything that he set his mind to do.
Henry Highland Garnet was an abolitionist and an educator.
Garnet had an opportunity to speak to Congress and was a powerful leader in a time when there were few black voices to be heard.
Henry Highland Garnet was an eloquent and radical voice for liberty from our very own Kent County.
Garnet spent much of his life fighting for freedom.
Garnet said that slaves should act for themselves to achieve total emancipation.
He reminded slaves that they were 4 million strong, and that they should fight, if need be, for their freedom.
Henry Highland Garnet urged American free blacks to claim their own destiny. For a period, he encouraged American free blacks to immigrate to Liberia.
In late 1881, the United States appointed a minister to Liberia. He went to Africa and died 2 months later.
Martin Luther King and Malcolm X took different routes toward trying to acquire freedom for black people. The same is true with Henry Highland Garnet and Frederick Douglass.
But he and Frederick Douglass differed in policies and approach to the anti-slavery movement, whereas Mr. Garnet was much more, fiery in his approach, whereas Frederick Douglass was more accommodating.
Frederick Douglass and Harriet Tubman. It's just amazing and really inspiring to think about how much those people accomplished against all odds with everything stacked against them. And to learn that they lived right here on the Eastern Shore, and in Garnet's case, right here in Kent County, it's just really, really interesting.
He injured his knee while playing sports. It never recovered. And his lower leg had to be amputated in 1839.
However, as Highland Garnet did prior to this, he continued to push forward.
He did not allow slavery or any amputated leg stop him from working the things that he believed in.
He believed in education and worked hard to acquire his, attending 2 schools before finishing his own education.
He apparently was the militant one to the more calm and acceptable other abolitionist, who was Frederick Douglass.
1824, him and his family asked permission to go to a funeral in Pennsylvania, but they later on continued and found a refuge in New York City, and that's where he stayed for a long period of time.
There in New York City, he put the children into school, and that's when he took the name of Henry Garnet.
Being a part of this school named after Henry Highland Garnet places us as a footnote in history.
The farmers in New Hampshire were up in an uproar because
having a school that accepted Negroes in their village. So they brought in 90 yoke of oxen and hooked them to the school and towed the school into the swamp and set it on fire. The kids, of course, were terrified, and Henry Highland Garnet and his friends retreated to their dormitory, and they were afraid that someone would come after them. Well, two men on horseback did, and he grabbed his musket and fired at them immediately. And his friends say that he saved their lives because the men did not come any farther.
40 years later, after the Civil War, he was on a tour of the South to investigate the condition of the freedmen. And his first stop was in Chesterville, where he had been a slave. And he wrote about that to a friend, that people treated him very well, even the whites who had slaves, and that they seemed to actually be proud that someone from Kent County had achieved such stature, even if it was an African American or a Negro.
Mrs. McBain once lived in Baltimore. She is now deceased. It was a wonderful activity, and she was delighted for us to bring her to Chestertown and honor her because of her great-great-grandfather, the Henry Highland Garnet. And here is a picture showing of her.
Although Henry Highland Garnet was born in Maryland, he decided later in life that he wanted to live in Liberia.
He returned to Kent County after the Civil War and spoke and preached to the crowd that had gathered to celebrate Decoration Day.
I painted this picture of Henry Highland Garnet.
If it wasn't for Garnet and the teachers, when I was coming up, I wouldn't have got to the place where I'm at today. Thank you.